Well, I really gotta say that, coming to the realization that, I'm stuck. Also brought me to an inside desperation to figure out what the hell I'm stuck on. Came up with a lot of stuff. And I thought it was those things. And then I thought about it and I'm like, I don't got that many feelings attached to that. I don't really think it's that. Well, a couple weeks ago, and I listened to a few different people online, but I wasn't listening to anything spiritual at the time. I was looking up possums and whatnot, seriously. And all of a sudden, this guy just comes on my YouTube and he starts talking. And I could not stop listening to him. I felt like it was drilling into my head. So I had to actually turn myself around. And I looked at this guy. And something about the things he said to me, or said to me, said to the world, lit up a really dark area that I really didn't even think about looking in. It's only been maybe a week, and I feel like with some of the advice and some of it was an understanding that he had. He explained some things about the dark night of the soul. And not in a pompous way or anything, but I really thought I was really past that. And I try to be as humble as I can about things that I know. I try not to make it come off like I know more than the other person, but a lot of people come to me and expect me to know more. And it's not like, it's like it's my duty to tell them. I mean, I don't know how to, if they ask me for it. Oh, don't get me wrong. I mean, if you ask my kids, I'm sure that I got tons of advice they never asked me for, and they just want me to shut up sometimes. And I really need to. Because that's a distraction. And it's also a projection. I feel like maybe through this guy, I got a glimpse at what being at a higher vibrational awareness would be like. There would be no falseness. Nobody would lie. Okay? There would be no reason to put on a face for anyone because you were being your authentic self. There'd be no shame, not about anything. you know? If there were two strangers, one was a victim and one was a perpetrator, you would have to balance your vision of that situation. You can't really hate. You can't hate yourself. And see, that's the thing. There's some things about myself that I really hate. And I pick on myself mentally, you know? You know, why'd you do it like that? That made you look stupid, you know? I mean, no wonder people say that to you, or no wonder, you know? And then I was getting these same feelings of like, yeah, you've done that your whole life kind of feeling, and like, you know, I was getting waves of emotion and sadness. Some of it was sadness, but a lot of it was anger. Now, not at anyone but myself. That's no shit. Unless they were an obvious perpetrator or hurting someone I love or something like that. And I'm telling you, I can get furious, like, out of control. I mean, I haven't been out of control since, you know, for many years, but that part of me is there, and it, I know, like, I could. And there's some things I tell myself that, you know, I could do this and I wouldn't feel bad about it. I could, you know, hurt someone else that's hurting my family, and I would think that I had the right to do it. And that's a lie. And that's part of my hump, is anger. And part of my anger, the hump to that, is bad feelings. Is places I've been hurt by people I couldn't be angry with. I don't have anyone. I mean, there's a lot that's happened to me in my lifetime, and people have hurt me, you know. I've been raped, I've been beat up, I've been turned out when I was a kid, when I was 15. Talk about being turned out of my house. So, those of you who know what I'm saying. I felt ugly. I felt fat. I was fat. I felt weird. Felt really alone, understood, misunderstood. I wanted to give people things so that they would think that I was a nice person. I felt like I was always trying to prove to people that I was a good person, that I was a good friend, that I was a good daughter, that I was a good granddaughter, that I was a good person. And it really hurt me when they didn't believe that. It really hurt me when they would accuse me of things that I would never ever think of doing. And I could never think of what about me makes them think that I would be that untrustworthy or that scandalous or that, diabolical, that I could come up with a plan to, like, purposely use someone or to help me take care of my kids or whatever, you know, stuff like that. And it would just, you know, like, oh, you planned this kind of thing, or boy, don't that work out for you, or whatever it was. I was just like, wow, really? I could. You know, I would minimize things because I didn't want people to be mad at me because they were jealous, or I would, whatever, dumb myself down. I mean, how many of us do that, you know, or have done it in the past, maybe, you know? It's like, oh yes, honey, you're so wise, and oh, this wonderful idea that he came up with when it was really you all along, and you fucking know it, whatever, you know? I've minimized my gifts to save my feelings. To save my family, to save my family's feelings more. And people that I care about. Because I know that, and I say this without, you know, trying to sound like I know that there's a lot of people that probably really won't like me when I've reached my true potential. They don't want me to. It's not because they don't want to see it. It's because it rises some kind of charge. It pulls a charge out of them that makes them feel like I'm either competing, or they have to compete, or that, you know, for some reason, it just magnifies some of the places that they want, they need to fix, maybe. I don't know. I mean, I'm not trying to, you know, but it's like someone with a drug problem, you know? I mean, you say, yeah, I don't want that person to not do drugs anymore. Or, you know, if you're with someone that drinks, I don't want them to drink anymore. Well, what about when they don't drink? They're just like a total fucking asshole, just sitting there, you know? No fun to them at all. Or maybe they won't need you anymore. Or maybe, you know, they'll get really angry if you don't, you know. There's a lot of reasons that the people closest to us don't want us to change. Because that means that their perception of you has been wrong. And people don't like being wrong, you know. And I've come kind of to realize that it really doesn't matter what other people think about me. It's really none of my business. You know, if they're hurting me with it, then I need to step way out of that line of fire, because that's, you know, you don't know why exactly that they're shooting that shit at you, you know? most of the time it's because it looks like something about to rip their own fears right out of their, like it's gonna uncover some things that maybe they don't want to face about themselves. The other thing too is that, you know, it breaks a connection. It breaks a connection that you have to that person. If it's someone that you've always catered to or tried to, you know, handle with kid gloves because you obviously care way more about their feelings than they do yours, it has to be something that you can do and give yourself distance so that you can gain strength, because it's like you have to be at a place of strength in your life. You have to find the courage to project the person that you feel that you are truly inside. And that's hard for me to do. It's really kind of beautiful in some ways how the synchronicities do come forth in our life. And the day before I had my stroke, I went to a Chinese restaurant and I got a fortune cookie that said, dare to be yourself no matter how strange and colorful that self may prove to be, something like that. And it's really hard for us to be ourselves or for other people that project a certain persona. I mean, we all change and move forward in our life. Those that don't want to do it are stuck in this resistance. They're stuck in this denial. They think that they have it all. They think that they got it down. Sometimes it's really a brutal denial. It's really a brutal resistance. And that comes out in racism and sexism and, you know, classism and all these things that we use to judge other people. But there's also a subtle resistance. And the closer that you become to your higher self, the closer you become to, you come to being able to differentiate the voices in yourself. About what is real and what is not, the more they start to sound alike. You know, through this last year, I found a place of quiet in my mind. And I left a lot of the things there for a rainy day. I had to have, because it's like a blur. I mean, I've struggled today a lot trying to put this video on. I felt really, really self-conscious. I felt like I wouldn't know what to say. I wrote down things many times, how it was gonna go, and I haven't even picked up that paper since it started. So, you know, now that I'm going, I feel like it's going pretty good because I feel good about it. I feel good that I am able to share this with all of you because, you know, I have felt like I've kind of let people down, you know. I wanted to bring a lot of women together and, you know, have a group and, you know, and I've just been stuck. But this video and the ones to come, I feel, are maybe that little push I need to get over that hump. And maybe talking some of these things through with you, maybe, you know, there'll be a connection there and, you know, we can support each other on this journey. I mean, it wasn't like I thought I was too big for my britches or anything. It might have perceived with that, but it wasn't really that. It was because I felt really small. It was because I felt really disconnected. And it's because I learned that that disconnection was a disconnection to my feelings. I've had this year to be able to reflect and think about, you know, what I really want to do when I grow up. A lot of times this year I've said, I just want to die and get this fucking shit over with. It's hard for me to say that because, you know, I have a lot of goodness in my life. But it's almost like not being grateful for that if you just want to leave it because you're sick of it. But this is something we all feel. We will all feel this as we begin our process of starting to listen to our soul and live our purpose in this loving ourselves. I do all the affirmations. I went through all emotions. I can read all the books. I can tell myself till the cows come home, I'm beautiful, I'm a goddess, I am a powerful woman. But my heart won't believe it. It won't believe it because it doesn't want to hear another lie. Doesn't want to be hurt anymore. No. Forgiveness? I thought I had that down. I have forgiveness for people that have hurt me. I do. I love that they have made me this person that I am. things that are uncomfortable in our life just need an adjustment. The sadness and things, I needed an adjustment so I could see things from a different perspective. And one of the biggest things that I have, that I've seen, and I do know, is that one of the things that I have seen, and I do know, is that